Your teardrop trailer should be like you when you go camping. You wear layers. Your teardrop should also have layers of protection for when you go camping. Hey campers, Mark here from OverlandTrailer.com, and we're going to talk about putting layers into your teardrop trailer build that will protect it from primarily two threats. Several years ago, I remember watching a documentary about the layers of protection that go into cybersecurity. Security and protection is really just about slowing down the imminent invasion of a threat. So when we're looking at the teardrop trailer, as you're building yours, you can build in layers of protection and security just like we would have in cybersecurity. Now, there are two different types of damage or threats to your teardrop trailer. The first one is Mother Nature, and that usually comes in the form of a fire or some sort of water damage. This is also the most common category for damage to occur in a teardrop trailer. The second category is human intervention, which is usually in the form of vandalism or theft. Now, it's important to note that building layers of security into your teardrop trailer is different than operating with layers of security when you're actually out camping. There are different practices and things that you can do when you're out camping. What we're going to focus on is, while you're building it, what can you build into the foundation of your trailer that will make it more secure or protect it? I'm going to cover 5 layers that you can build into your teardrop and 1 bonus at the very end. The very first layer is simply visual. If I walk up to a teardrop trailer, can I see locks? Can I see stickers for maybe security systems or trackers or something else that would indicate that there's a system on board that I may not want to mess with? Now, those two things are mostly to slow down potential theft or damage, but there's also a visual inspection that I can do of the trailer to see if it is weatherworthy. In Idaho, we can be below 0 degrees Fahrenheit or above 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and that means a lot of materials in my trailer will expand and contract a fair bit throughout the course of the year, which means I'm just gonna check it a few more times per year to make sure those seals are still good. All right, this is layer number 2. You right now are sitting in the electrical box of this teardrop trailer, which is part of the structure and construction of this trailer. So let's start by talking about wiring. As you build your trailer, you can build it in such a way that will make sure that it lasts a long time, but also make sure that it's safe. The first thing is to make sure that your wire is set up for the appropriate amount of electricity that's going to be going through it. In a 12-volt system in a teardrop trailer, that is typically going to be 14 gauge wire if it's going from your fuse block to an appliance like a fan or a light. If it's coming from the battery to the fuse block, I always like to beef up my wire for that connection, because all of the 12 volt electricity will be traveling from the battery through that fuse block, and I want to make sure that it is well within the constraints of the wire. So I will usually use a 10 or a 12 gauge wire for that, and I almost always go waterproof. Now, I mentioned the fuse block. You want to make sure that every circuit has the appropriate fuse for the appropriate amount of draw. I like a fuse block that has a nice cover over the top of it, so none of the fuses can be accidentally bumped or hit by something metal, which will short them out. Now, as you're putting wiring into your trailer, you want to make sure you don't have any extreme bends in your wires. Something that is like that would be too much of a bend, and the wire could break, potentially shorting, potentially starting a fire. The other reason you don't want a lot of bends is because those bends usually are over a sharp surface that can eventually wear its way through the insulation of the wire, creating a bit of a fire hazard. Now, if you have a wire that is like this, you can put it inside a wire loom, which will protect the outside even more. Story time. I used to be a teacher, and at one of the schools that I worked at, every year we would take 100+ high school seniors out into the woods for a week to teach them survival skills. And I would always take my teardrop trailer to sleep in, because I didn't need to survive, I needed to teach. One night I woke up and I could hear something outside my door. It was about 3 o'clock in the morning. There was something I could vaguely see out through the window. They couldn't see in, and so I waited until there was a shape right in front of my window, and I flipped on my porch light. Boom! Travis was standing there TPing my trailer. So the next day, let's say there was a little bit of payback. But that is the advantage of outdoor lighting. Outdoor lighting not only provides a little layer of security in case somebody has worse intentions than throwing toilet paper at your trailer, it also provides you a little bit of perspective, because maybe there's an animal approaching, you can turn on the light and see what's going on outside. It's also important to install everything on the outside of your trailer with the appropriate sealing methods, whether that's a roof fan like this that has silicone covering all the screw holes and around the outside, but it also has a gasket underneath, or it's the roof trim that goes on with a butyl tape underneath, then it's applied, and then you can also put a silicone along the edges. You can also put layers of protection underneath the skin of your trailer to protect it from water or to direct any leaks out a certain way so that you can find the leaks quickly and be able to take care of them. Another simple security thing is to install your coupler by welding it on. If your coupler is bolted on, that's quick and easy to install, but it's also quick and easy to uninstall if you have a lock on the ball. Then a thief can come along, take out the bolts, drag your trailer away, bye-bye trailer. If you weld this on, it doesn't give that option to a potential thief. Alternatively, you could do like I did with my very first teardrop and put a removable tongue on it so that you can remove the tongue, and if somebody wants to steal it, they're gonna have an awful hard time dragging that thing away. When I built my first teardrop, I remember reading a debate that was going on a forum online about the hardware that's used to install the doors into the teardrop body. There were some of the opinion that you needed to use some sort of obscure hardware so that it would take some special bit to get this out. Then there were those like myself who ended up saying just use typical hardware, because if a thief shows up, they're going to get in no matter what. And if they have to break something and tear the whole thing apart because you have weird hardware on here, that's just going to cause more damage. So I use typical hardware. If somebody wants to get in, they can remove all of that, not that I want them to, and it minimizes the damage to my trailer. The thing that goes along with that is I don't keep anything especially valuable inside my trailer. The third layer of protection for the teardrop trailer are primarily add-ons, and those are mostly for safety. For instance, in the galley area where I'm going to be doing a lot of cooking on my open flame stove, I will have a fire extinguisher. Finding one that's small enough for your teardrop has been a bit of a challenge, but thankfully First Alert makes this one, and it stows very nicely in the galley area. Yeah, I'm giving up a little bit of room in my galley for silverware or something else, but at the same time, if I have a fire, I have a fire extinguisher right here. I'll put a link to it down below if you want to get one yourself. Another add-on that I put in a teardrop trailer is a smoke detector. I will usually put this inside the cabin area where people will be sleeping. This one is nice and thin, which is what I like about it, because this is a fairly small space. You don't want to bump your head on something, but there's a slightly thicker version that also includes a carbon monoxide sensor, so you could have smoke and carbon monoxide in the same unit. Now, you can also upgrade your trailer with a Wi-Fi connection, and you can have smart devices like this that will send you an alert should it sense smoke or carbon monoxide when you're not anywhere near your trailer. That is something that I'm going to cover in potentially a future video, but for now, just a basic smoke detector is an excellent add-on to have in your teardrop. Our fourth layer is focused on protection, and that is mostly against thieves and or vandals. The first thing I'm going to mention in this list is a GPS tracker. GPS trackers historically have been a little bit too bulky, weird for a teardrop trailer just because they're too big or the power constraints or something like that, but they're coming out now much smaller and more portable and easier to use, like this WearSafe unit here. If you want to know more about it, there's a link down below. I'm going to do an entire video on this, but for now, let me tell you that this thing can track where my trailer is, plus a bunch of other stuff, and it's just a nice layer of protection so that if I'm not around my trailer and my trailer starts to move, this thing will send me updates. In fact, it just buzzed my phone to let me know that somebody moved the unit within the trailer itself. So I just install it on this metal plate here because it's magnetic, easy. And just like that, I have another layer of protection. Let's talk about door locks for a second, because this is a very common door type and they typically come with this latch bolt style lock. And the nice thing about them is that you can lock the latch so you can't open the latch. And then I can also engage the deadbolt with this other right here. Now, as great as it is to have two lock options on the door as opposed to the vintage style trailers that have like a L handle or a T handle or something that has just one lock option, they are still mass produced. And unlike automobiles, the lock sets for these are not very diverse, which means if I have a key to one of these quite common locks, I might be able to just get into your trailer because I have the correct key for the tumblers that are already in your doors. So something that you could do to increase the protection of your trailer is to switch this out for a different lock that has a combination pad and locks, or you could get a locksmith to come and just switch these tumblers to make them very unique. Another layer of protection that we can add to a teardrop trailer that's mostly from you and me, especially if you go off-road, is to get some sort of backup camera. And this can be installed right here on the back of the trailer itself. I think this is most useful when backing up a teardrop trailer on a trail. I drove up a two-track with the Jeep and my first trailer a long time ago and got up to the top of this fire lookout, and there was actually only one way back and I couldn't turn around, so I had to back my trailer down a fairly steep rock, not road, but like trail, and then get down to a point where I could actually turn around and get out. And this would have been very, very handy for that, to see any stumps, trees, rocks, and other things that were coming in the direction of the trailer. Now, I mentioned this in another video about how to physically protect the battery of your trailer. And this trailer actually doesn't have a battery right now, but a nice place to tuck it is right back here behind the tire. If the tire is leaning back just a little bit, it's a nice physical barrier in case somebody decides to steal your battery. They also have to take off this entire spare tire rack before they get to it. Again, it's not gonna stop them, but it will slow them down and give more time for somebody to see what's going on. All right, the bonus layer is coming up, but first let's do layer 5 of protection, which is financial protection. It is important as you start your DIY build to call your insurance company and tell them what you're doing, because they'll be able to provide you with information that will help you either save money on your policy or protect your RV even better as you build it or after it is built. For instance, some insurance companies will give you a discount if you have a security system or GPS tracker in your RV. Another thing you want to document in case there is the need to file a claim on your teardrop trailer is all of the serial numbers or VIN numbers that go into your trailers. It's worth writing down the model numbers, the serial numbers, all of that stuff to document for later on. That sounds like a lot of work, so actually the best way to do it, and the way I've always done it, is just to shoot photos of all those tags on all of those things and put them in a folder so that if the worst happens and I need them, I have them right there and I can pull all the numbers off at that time. Let's say the very worst happens and somebody steals your trailer, the one that you spent so much time on. What is the procedure with your insurance company so you can move quickly with them? What do they recommend as you work with law enforcement to try and find that asset again? Those are all excellent questions to have answered up front so you don't have to figure them out at the time. And if a trailer is stolen, time is important. So having that already figured out is another layer of protection. Now, the last thing in the financial layer of security for your trailer is a little bit subjective. So you'll just need to figure this out with your insurance company on your own. Some teardrop builders will build a teardrop trailer on top of a utility trailer, and others will build a custom frame for it. Either way, the frame will have a VIN number on it from the state that authorizes it to be on the road. That VIN number will match a certain type of trailer. So it could be a utility trailer or it could be an RV. As far as the state is concerned, generally speaking, they won't care, but your insurance company may care how it's coded. If you have a teardrop trailer body on a utility trailer and it's lost in damage or stolen, the insurance company may look at that and go, oh, you have a utility trailer, and they will pay out the value of an equal sized utility trailer minus your deductible. But that does not make up for the overall value because you turned it into an RV.
That's an RV.
It's going to be completely up to you, your insurance agency, your local laws, etc., but it is worth the conversation. Bonus round, the ultimate layer of protection for your teardrop trailer is you. You will have more knowledge of your RV than the average RV owner, which means you can build in systems of protection against water, fire, and people with bad intentions. And your knowledge of it will be absolutely critical should you have to provide documentation to a state or insurance company for a claim. Hey, do you want to learn more about that GPS tracker? When the video is published, it'll be right over here, and I will give you all of the possible details for this device.